Welcome to part two. We have windows and door frames and a beautiful Banksia. This is basically where we began. This is around the 10th of December. So the back of the house, which is just behind Reese, had begun. Very exciting. This is all the bricks, quite obviously. I just do a few of these panning shots at the start of this video and then I'll go into, you know, talking in the actual video, but just giving you an idea of how it's looking. Door frames are up, some of the window, like, because we're having a gabled pitched roof in the main living areas, so in the footage coming up after this you will see that. But yeah, just the beginning of something great. So we're at the block, the bricks have been delivered. We had no idea it would be at this stage. We were told that would start working around the time that they've done like all of this, which is super exciting. It feels like the first step towards the actual house existing. It's one thing to have, you know, the earthworks completed and that kind of thing, but to actually see bricks here and walls go up and the door frames and the, I put my hat on, and the windows and that kind of thing. I'm gonna wear it like this so that the branding is out of frame. that makes it so much more real. Like being able to see what view you're going to get from each window or door is so cool. Yeah, so cool. They've delivered a lot more bricks since that last bit of footage where we were like, I don't think there's enough bricks. We have been told that they had everything ready to go and prepped and done, but, ooh, black cockatoos. At the rate they're going, surely they're not gonna take too much longer, which is so exciting. I just wanted to update you guys that it's begun, it's on its way. From now on, we'll be vlogging the house going up. A few questions about people. I think each state, and obviously each country, builds houses differently. So in WA, we still build with, like, what's called double brick walls. I know basically every other state, they use timber frames, and then they put brick around it, or they just use timber frames, or whatever. There's a whole lot of debate whether or not double brick is outdated or whether or not it's good. I don't know. I don't really care. It was just what we were given. So we took it, and surprisingly we didn't have a very long wait with bricks, which was also very surprising. We were thinking it was going to be months, like 3 or 4 months, but we ended up being like second in line, so pretty much straight away, which is really cool. And hoping we're going to be ahead of the bottleneck for the roof carpentry too. Those trades have the biggest delays at the moment. Brickies and the roof carpenters. And especially it would rain. I just hate the heat. I hate it. I really did not enjoy it. Recently I'm thinking that we're going to maybe get a pool. It's very tempting to. Oh my god, he's made a makeshift ladder to try and trim some of the thatch off a really tall grass tree. Oh god. I can't watch these things. Damn it. Boys have like no sense of threat or danger. It's just, I will do this. Anyway. So we're thinking about putting a pool in. Not sure. Like a little plunge pool, not a big one, like a 4x3 or something like that. Anyway, a little update for you. Thank you for watching so far. Don't forget to follow Loz Curtis Home. And yeah, stay tuned. P.S. This is what Reese is doing. God help me. Oh man.
You can see the pitched roof getting prepped. The walls, they're coming. They're getting there. Yeah, this is kind of, I film every single time we visit the block. And so it's exciting for me. But then when I think about this video, it's just like the smallest changes in each video clip. But anyway, hey, this is our view from the kitchen. Then we've got the scullery and then the door. Well, not the door. Yeah, that's the view from the scullery. Then this window is the view from the mudroom. So basically the same view.
We just got here. And we have our first few internal walls. Wow, this is so weird. A room. Oh, wow. Door frames.
Wow. Or a little rove. Now we can see the actual view. I know, like, it's super bunkery because we're so low, but I actually love it. I find that so cozy. So this is my makeup room. What's the view like here? Basically the same. Let me zoom out. It is a nice view. So what's this? That is bathroom, spare bathroom. Okay, now we're walking into another spare bedroom. That's a tiny toilet door.
Is it really meant to be that small?
Surely, no, that's not.
The smallest toilet door I've ever seen.
That's the smallest toilet door I've ever seen. So this is the other, woo, it echoes. Spare bedroom, which is at the moment looking into sand that will eventually be covered with stuff, but that's a beautiful view too. I think I almost discounted this view. I almost like this view more than the side views. It's hard to see from this shot, but it's a bloody beautiful room. Checking out the different possible render colors. We chose this one originally, but we were worried that when it's in the shade, it was going to be too dark and too similar to the color of the roof. So we've got these samples, which are much lighter. Put them half in the shade, half in the sun. Still pretty happy with that middle color. We have narrowed it down to two colors now and decided to take them to the block so we could compare against the water tank, which is our roof color. This is the lighter gray, the darker gray. We thought this one was going to be too dark, but now that we've taken it here and compared it against the color bond, we actually think we're going to stick with our original choice. After all, just got to the block. Super windy. More has been done. Mudroom, scullery, kitchen, activity, bathroom, toilet, bedroom. And the garage wall has got going up as well. From inside, doors, living area, dining area. The living area, the fireplace will be here. Ooh, it's windy. Looking fabulous. Check it out from this view. Ooh, yeah. It's nice having the higher up vantage point because then we can get a really nice idea of how it's all coming together. So exciting. Gosh, it's been windy these past few days. Look at those trees. Jeez. Bathroom wall has gone up. Garage. Toilet. Shower. Bathroom. Bedroom. Garage. This was an exciting visit because the walls finally started going up in the other wing of the house. They started going up in the area of the house that we're not going to be using very often, like all the spare bedrooms and stuff. So it didn't really feel as... No, it was still really exciting, but it wasn't as exciting as this area. This is the theater room looking out. It's unfortunate that the couch is going to be against the window, so you're not going to be looking at a wall instead of that beautiful view. But the bricks were raised to the left of the screen on that wall because we have a nice high ceiling. As you can see, it goes up. I keep mentioning this in the other videos, but there you go. So I'm just taking you around again. This is one of our living spaces. So we'll have a fireplace right in the middle where that middle pole is. That's going to be so nice. And then as we walk through, you're looking at, this is our kitchen where Mimi is. That's our other living area. Now she's going into the hallway. She just loves it. She keeps eating the tradies crumbs though, and she gets sick the next day. like she can only find them. I don't know where they are until she comes out and she's got like crumbs in her mouth. So annoying, but anyway. So we also have our bathroom. Oh my gosh. So this is our bedroom right now, and this is our master bathroom, like our ensuite. In the middle is the vanity, and then in here is our shower. That window is quite low, but it's okay. It'll be frosted. And then here is our little, what's it called? Shower recess thing where you put your shampoos and stuff. And that whole space isn't obviously done yet. So yes, we'll have two basins here. It looks a bit small. I mean, it is fairly small compared to our first house. It's about the same as our rental now. But the first house that we bought, the two-story one, we were very much spoilt with room because it was built for a family and it was just us two. Even though this house is for a family as well. But this is the toilet, obviously. That window will also be frosted. It is kind of weird that our bedroom is next to the driveway, but we have a beautiful view from our bedroom. This is obviously nothing. I'm just talking to you guys. This footage isn't showing you anything. It just gives me the opportunity to keep talking without having to just find filler footage. Anyway, Reese is so funny. He's so particular with things. There's a door at the back of the house that he's so frustrated about. But I think I mentioned it? The really, really narrow one. We're going to keep it as is, because of a few reasons. But anyway, random, sidetracked. This is the view from our bedroom. Stunning, stunning, gorgeous, stunning. Cannot wait until this is done. It shouldn't be too long now. This is the 25th of January that I'm recording this. Hopefully only a week or two longer. All right, we've just arrived. Sorry if it's a bit windy. Let me zoom out. The brickies are now done. Here we have the garage. How big is it? 6x6? A little bit bigger than a standard one to fit the cars. Memes would like to welcome you inside. So yes, mudroom, scullery, main living areas. Ooh, it's done. Wow, fireplace. Let's go see the grass trees here. Yeah. We love how this tree is just perfectly framed from the front.
This is the wall in comparison. Don't mind my outfit. I was not planning on being on camera. Yes. To give you a perspective of how tall the roof is. I'll take you through this way, sir. Bathroom, two basins, window. It used to be down here, but we lifted it because that's a much better size. And it wasn't really like, wasn't it more of a square? No, okay, I'm just making up lies, that's good. Poop station.
Okay, I decided to record a proper tour of the house. Here is the garage. Now we're walking through the mudroom, which contains our washers, dryers, you know, it's basically just our laundry. And then through to the next room is the scullery, or the, what's it called? The name escapes me, but it's where our fridge will be, and extra storage, cupboards, food storage, basically just hiding all that stuff away. Butler's pantry, that's the word, I got it. This is the first living space. We will have the fireplace there, and then through this window you'll have we will have, actually, maybe not you guys, but we will have a deck that Reese will install. And then here we have the kitchen. That horizontal window is where our range hood and our stove will be. And Mimi is walking through the hallway. This is our second living space. We will have a beautiful high roof. We'll have a high roof on both of these living areas. The gabled roof, can't wait until that's installed. Beautiful huge windows, love it. Now we're looking through the activity room. Look at the wind blowing through her fluff, just in her element. Not really sure what we're going to use the activity room for. Perhaps an office, not sure yet. It's a little bit small to do too much with, but we'll figure it out. Next we're walking into my makeup room. Can't wait to fit this out. stoked, excited. Then we've got our first bedroom and then our second spare bedroom. Ooh, skipping past those apparently. Ensuite. No, this is not an ensuite. This is a spare bathroom, a toilet. We are keeping the door off center like that, much to Reese's dismay. It just makes it easier to open the door. And it was too expensive to change it anyway, so we're just leaving it as is. Reese will never ever come to terms with it, but that's all right. Walking through the house to get to the theater room, Mia's paws are soaked. She apparently likes walking through puddles. Who would have known? Not me, because she hates water. Theater room, beautiful view. Shame you don't really see it when you're sitting down, but you know it's there. It's there in spirit. We've got our linen closet, and now you're walking through this little walkway to get to our bedroom. The roof is meant to be going up in a week. I mean, end of February, probably beginning of March. They're estimating if the timber arrives on time. I'm filming this on the 23rd of February, so cross your fingers for us, hey? Not much you can do. This is our closet, our walk-in wardrobe. It's quite tight, but Reese has done an awesome job of picking and designing certain IKEA wardrobes that will fit perfectly in here, and it will maximize storage space. Of course, our bathroom, not stoked with the brickwork on the corner of this shower wall. As you can see, it's a bit sloppy. Not going to be fun for the gyp rocker to have to deal with that. Anyway, toilet. Yeah, you've already seen all of this. But thanks for watching, guys. I hope you've enjoyed the journey so far. This is the last video in our part two. Sorry, this is the last update for the part two of our building journey. The next video will be part three, and that will be the roof, I would assume. And then gyp rocking and all that kind of stuff. So I hope you've been enjoying it. Don't forget to follow Loz Curtis Home for more updates. And we will see you next time. Look how majestic Mia looks with the wind just blowing through her hair. Anyway, bye guys.